Extend our heartfelt appreciation to the missionaries, GolerMet Booster Ministry, Stewart Chapel, New Hope, and the Goler Church family for your generous donation of adult protective underwear given to senior services. We were able to provide 62 packs of men and women underwear. A special thank you to Mr. Ron Ellaby and Mr. Robert Jackson for loading the cars. Rhonda Johnson, District Supply Secretary, and Stella Davis, Local Supply Secretary. Remember our sick and our shut-in members with your calls, your prayers, and pray for their healing, pray for the healing for our family as well as our friends. For our pastor, we know that today is Pastor Appreciation Day. So our pastor is a man of God who's led by him above. His mind is full of wisdom, his heart is filled with love. We're so thankful he's been called to spiritually lead our flock. His goal is our salvation, our pastor, our friend, our rock. Have a blessed week.
Thank you. of the Lord. Our scripture lesson today is out of the Old Testament, the second book, Exodus, chapter 17, verses 11 through 15. Exodus, chapter 17, 11 through 15. And I'm reading out of the New King James Version. And it reads, "And so it was when Moses held up his hand that Israel prevailed. And when he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. But Moses' hands became heavy. So they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat on it. And Aaron and Ur supported his hands, one on one side and the other on the other side. And his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. So Joshua defeated Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. Then the Lord said to Moses, write for a memorial in the book and recount it in the hearing of Joshua, that I will utterly blot out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. And Moses built an altar and called its name, the Lord is my banner." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
It is prayer time in the house. And we've all gone through something this week. But the operative word is, and we are still here, and we are yet alive to give God the praise and the glory. There are some that are struggling with different issues in life, but God is able, and all we have to do is continue to look to Him. The altar is open for you to come just to whisper your separate prayer before we go before God collectively. The altar is open. Won't you come? All you have to do is just tell it to Jesus. He's a healer. He's a way maker.
Come before your throne
presence, God. And sometimes we come before you, oh God, in a hurry. And we don't stand still enough to listen to what you're saying to us. Open up our ears right now. Settle our hearts. Settle our minds that we are focused on you. That we will hear from you in this moment. God, we thank you. We thank you for being a healer. We thank you for being a way maker. We thank you most of all, oh Lord, for blowing the breath of life into us one more time and allowing us to awaken this morning. Lord, there's some that had anticipation of waking up this morning, but you called them home. God, we thank you for your spirits that continue to be around us. We ask, oh God, that you will continue to allow your Holy Spirit to encompass us and to strengthen us and to guide us. God, we love you. We honor you and we praise you this day for who you are and what you have done, are doing, and will do. God, we thank you for all the way making that you do for us. We thank you for being that hedge of protection in the midst of a storm. You are that shelter. God, we thank you. Now, Lord, some of your children are gathered around this altar with their own needs. I ask, oh God, that you would come right now and meet them at their very point of need. Touch and heal and encourage, touch and lift up and build and give a holy boldness to each and every one of us, oh God, that we will be the disciples that you have called us to be. Now, God, we thank you for this man of God that you have put in this place for such a time as this. We thank you, oh God, for continuing to strengthen him and to continuously guide him and continuously leading him that he may lead us, oh God. We ask, oh God, that you would forgive us for the doubts that we have had about anything that you have told us to do. God, I ask that you will continue to be with his helping as she walks by his side and works hand in hand with him for the kingdom. We've come to the end of another conference here, oh God, and ask, oh God, that you would look at our hearts and that we will be, that you will see that we have been or try to at least be good stewards over what you have called us to do. We thank you, oh God, for those that have gone before us. We thank you, oh God, for those that will come. We thank you, oh God, and we ask that you would go with us even as we go into this annual conference, that you would have your way in each and every one of our lives. We honor you, oh God, and we bless your holy name. Now, God, I ask that you would be with the man of this hour. And as he stands behind this sacred desk, I ask, oh God, that you would decrease him, that you would increase in him, that your light will shine brightly, and that you will give him a holy boldness when he opens his mouth, that we will hear from you and not from him. Then open up our hearts, oh God, and our souls, that his words will take root, or your words will take root into our hearts and grow, that we will be the disciples you have called us to be. Bless us in this time together, and we will always be so careful as to give your name the honor, the glory, and the praise, because it's in the mighty, matchless, magnificent name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we ask that you would hear our prayer, incline thine ear to us, and grant us your peace. And the church of God said, amen.
Amen.
Mrs. Rita Kilgore will come at this time for our memorial moment.
There is a place of quiet rest near to the heart of God, a place where sin cannot molest, near to the heart of God. There is a place of comfort sweet near to the heart of God, a place where we, our Savior, meet, near to the heart of God. There is a place of full release near to the heart. A place where all is joy and peace, near to the heart of God. As we remember those who have gone before us, we are comforted in knowing they are near to the heart of God, unseen, unheard, but always near, still loved, still missed, and very dear. We will ask Rev.George to give us our prayer of remembrance.
Let us pray. Lord God, I ask right now that you continuously keep them in your loving, comforting arms. We thank you, Lord God, for the angels that you have allowed to walk amongst us for just a little while. Now, Lord, I ask that you would be with each and every one of their families and be with the Goler family as we continue to heal from the loss of their presence. But we know, O God, that earth has no sorrow that you cannot heal, and that to be absent in the body is to be present with you. So we rejoice that they are with you. Be with each of us continuously. Thank you for allowing them to walk with us. Be with their families. In Jesus' name, amen. We will now have the dance ministry to come and minister to us.
Thank you.
Somebody lift your voice into the Lord. Tell God, I'm going to press a little further. Press in your presence.
You are, 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 you are,
Peace.